I just came out of the session called Powerful Storytelling, where the star was Ken Watanabe, the Japanese actor. He was terrific explaining his experience of making a movie like a gift for those people who lost their houses, their jobs, or their dear ones in the tsunami in Japan. So after visiting them in the moment of the worst moments, he promised them all he was going to do another movie because that's all he does. And he already showed them the movie he had promised. So he told this story and read a poem of a Japanese author who died in an earthquake and was born in the first big tsunami. So it was very touching, his contribution to the roundtable. The roundtable was moderated by Jeff Fager, the producer of 60 Minutes. You can imagine he did a terrific job. Uwana Ugoban, from a radio station in Nigeria, also explained us how she does her job of telling stories of people, making them personal, very touching. We listened to one of these stories. By the way, the subject of her journalism was herself, the mother being battered by the father, an abused woman whom she interviewed. And Augustin Maurus, the cellist, he told us why he plays the bass he does in his cello in total darkness. Why does he look for a new media for a classic? Very interesting the way he talked about it. And finally, me, Carmen Gordiosa, Mexican writer, I spoke of what I think is the power of storytelling, the importance of still continuing telling stories, and how they've always given us a meaning of ourselves, and how, as the Sheher Esad story explains, they are there also to not only keep us away from death, but also make the tyrant get away of his illegitimate position. That's it in a very small summarizing of what the roundtable was.